Hey guys, it's Firestar here, and welcome back to another episode of Let's Play Pokemon Stadium 2. Last episode, we finished off everything in the Poke Cup. We finished the Master Ball division, and you know, we're free as a bird now. So, for today's episode, before we even take on the Prime Cup, we're gonna take on the last set of lectures here in Earl's Pokemon Academy. So we're gonna take on the Elite Four class set of lectures that we got in store for us. Multiplied damage, support moves, boosting tactics, boost combos, yada yada yada. We know this stuff, but for completion's sake, we are gonna do it. So let's just jump right in with multiplied damage. So this essentially just explains how multipliers work. Pretty much same type attack bonus applies 1.5 times damage. Crits apply 2 times damage. Super effective moves apply two times damage. And if like a specific type of move is effective with both types of a dual type Pokemon, then it'll be times 4. So say like Pikachu uses like Thunderbolt on a Gyarados. You got the 1.5 times 4 from the stat plus the times 4 for its weakness to water and flying, which in turn makes the damage to 6 times its intended damage, since it all is multiplicative. And factoring in moves, and then factoring like weather stuff like Rain Dance and Sunny Day, the water and fire type moves used while those weathers are up respectively are increased by 1.5 as well. So another factor to consider. Hold items like the type hold items like Charcoal, Miracle Seed, all of them. They increase the multiplier of that move by 1.1. And Light Ball and Vic Club for Pikachu and Cubomera respectively doubles the physical attack power. Yada yada yada. Weez time. With our question, which item doubles the physical attack power of Cubone? Vic Club. See, I am smart. I am smarter than you, El. Alright, support moves. Support moves are pretty much moves that do not do damage, that have some kind whose only effect is the negative drawback. So like a move that only reduces stats, like Screech or something, or moves that inflict status effects like Toxic or it's not in this game, but Will-O-Wisp is the quickest thing I can think of. Leech Seed, those are all status moves. There are two types of support moves, ones that work regardless of type matchup and are affected by the type matchup. So like For instance, like, Grass Pokemon can't be hit by Leech Seed. In this game, well, in any game, actually. It's only in 6th Gen on that Grass Pokemon move immune to, like, Pyro-type moves, but you get the idea, like, Grass Pokemon can't be Leech Seed, Fire Pokemon can't be burned, Poison Pokemon cannot be Toxic. In this generation, Electric Pokemon can get paralyzed, so that was, got rid of with X and Y. But Earl's also mentioning, like, we all know how normal Pokemon are immune to ghost moves, how dark Pokemon are immune to psychic moves. A normal type will still be affected by Confuse Ray, and a dark type will still be affected by moves like Hypnosis, essentially. Since some, all this basic stuff on Steel Times, we talked about that. Mentioned that already. Quiz! Quiz me, bitch. Quiz me. What is your question? Thunder Wave is ineffective against which type of Pokemon? Ground, because it is an electric type attack, and ground type shorted out. I don't know. Moves and tactics. General. Hope you can make it the slowness, but using the right moves and tactics. Okay, so this is essentially Earl's pretty much going to tell you how to play Pokemon, because essentially what he's going to be talking about is how effective certain battle tactics can be. Like, if you want to attack before your opponent, use a priority type move, like a quick attack, extreme speed, mock punch. Or, if you want to move first, be faster, essentially. If you want to also move first, use moves that slow people down, like Icy Wind and such. Or paralyzing. If you know you can't act first, then either be able to recover health on your second turn, like recover, pain split, that's the bomb if you know you're gonna die. If you know you're gonna fall to a specific amount of HP, reversal and stuff can work. It's essentially playing smart to knowing, and all of this is essentially being able to play smart based on the type of Pokemon you are facing. Whether it is fast, whether it is slow, whether it's defensive, whether it's heavily offensive, knowing that and it's in the typing can help you kind of formulate a strategy against said Pokemon. That's the gist of what it'll say. Anyway, each move increases speed, agility, because agility is gotta go fast, but not as fast as Sonic, because no one can be fast as Sonic, silly boy. Multi-type moves. Okay, it's essentially Earl's talking about teaching your Pokemon of a wide array of moves with different types. That way, you have different coverage over a lot of things. Like for instance, teaching Cubone with Blizzard, don't ever do that. Or Arbok with Earthquake. Can't even learn Earthquake? Sure, or like the Typhlosion I made up when I played this game way back when I gave it like Thunder Punch and Earthquake, that way it can cover like a bunch of stuff. That is essentially what Earl is trying to say. Just have a wide variety of attacks that we can cover different things. Squeeze! If Starmie is to be thought a move it hates, which of the following should it be taught? Kanda. Though I would think it hates frustration too, because no one likes to be mad. Nobody likes to be mad. Move combos. Combination of moves. Essentially, I already know it is gonna come up. Defense, curl, and rollout. You use defense, curl in the first turn. Rollout's power is doubled. Yada yada yada. See. Or moves like Lock On that ensure that your next move actually hits. It'll even hit if a Pokemon's up in the air or underground, which is why Lock On's useful. It's also useful for if you want to hit with like a move that has low accuracy, but the effect of Lock On does go away if the opponent switches out. Then the Endure Reversal Flail combo. And then Belly Drum, and then holding like a Mint Berry, or a Citrus Berry, or something of the sort, or in this game it'd be a Gold Berry, but you get the idea. You get it, right? You get the idea, you get it. Wasted. What move power is doubled if it is used after defense curl? Rollout, because that is like the most basic thing you will learn in this game. Pretty basic. Oh lord. Oh god, six more lectures. Oh Jesus. Situational combos. What's the situational combo? Playing around your opponent again. Your opponent is minimized. You just stomp it, crush it into a pancake. It does double damage. If you put a Pokemon to sleep, or the opponent goes to sleep with like rest or anything, Dream Eater or Nightmare. Nightmare dealing what, an eighth or fourth of the damage while it's asleep, and Dream Eater is just pretty much an empowered Giga Drain that you can only use while the opponent's sleeping. And then using Morning Sun, Moonlight, and Synthesis in the sun increases their health significantly compared to, and in the rain that healing is halved. Yada yada yada. Then like rain and thunder. Sun and solar beam. You get this stuff. You get this stuff. That's why I'm not really explaining so much, because you get the basic understanding of what Earl's trying to say. Okay, Quiz. What move's power is doubled if used against a target that used minimize stump? I believe there's another move that in later gens that does that too, but I forget which one it is. I forget. Okay. More on switching! it's against smart defense for... He's talking about switching defensively in the case of bringing in a Pokemon who can resist the type that you are against. Oh my god, I am slipping on so many words. Oh, offensive mind is switching what he's talking about. Oh, okay. Let me illustrate this. Let's assume you have an electric type Pokemon now. And let's assume the foe uses a ground type. Okay, so switching to like a water. Either a water type or a flying type since it's immune to ground. Mm-hmm. Ground types also resist. Yeah. Switching based on typing to give you an advantage. That is the switching lecture in a nutshell. Switching Pokemon is very important. What is necessary for switching? Was I really just asked that question? Was I really? Reading the situation, let's see what Earl says here. Attacking the type matchup weaknesses of Pokemon is a basic strategy. However, depending on the situation, doing so isn't necessarily the best course of action. Consider a battle between a Tauros and a Mantine. Let's assume Tauros used Thunder. You'll probably consider yourself lucky. Would be cool. But if Thunder is a special attack, that means... Always, essentially, what Earl's talking about is be mindful of which kind of attack, which Pokemon uses what type of attack. Because Tauros using Thunder on a Mantine, while that sounds good on paper, Tauros has horrendous special attack. Therefore, despite Thunder being four times effective, it won't kill Mantine. Mantine will probably live at like half. So just kind of be mindful of your Pokemon stats and the specific type of move that Pokemon uses corresponds with the stat that Pokemon is stronger with. If that makes any sense, I'm pretty sure it doesn't, but please. Which move is powered up 1.5 times if it is used by Tauros? Why are you asking a stat-based question on this? Well, I've been skimming through your lecture because I already know all this stuff, and I assume you guys do too, so... Reading the foe's moves. Reading your rival... Battle's gone away with a grass-type Meganium facing off against the water-type Azumarill. Would be dandy. Okay, so it's essentially. Essentially, what Earl's talking about is just a common strategy used in a lot of competitive battles. Being able to read the situation. If you have a matchup that that your Pokemon struggle against, your opponent might switch out to something that resists it. So. If you feel like your opponent's gonna switch out, use a move that will. If you can predict what he's switching into, you can use a move that can effectively. That's more effective against the switch as opposed to the Pokemon that's right in front of you. But in the event that he doesn't switch, you want to be able to pick a move that covers both ends. The Pokemon you're currently against and the Pokemon you think the opponent might switch into is essentially what he's saying. It's a very common strategy in competitive play, and I guess. The higher level you go, the more punishing being wrong with the prediction is. Which normal type move can be learned by Meganium? Oh my god, I didn't read it in the Earl voice. Oh Jesus Christ, I'm a failure. Hold items. Wild Pokemon can have hold items. Why is this relevant in this game? Oh, geez. Okay. Why was this lecture even here? Just give me the damn question. Why is Clefairy maybe holding an item other than Mystery Berry? What item is it?
Moonstone.
He's supposed to be giving me battle tips. Like, I have, in fact, uses a holding specific items in battle. Now that would have been a good lecture. Maybe if you might come back and find an egg.
About eggs.
My main egg? Some Pokemon are compatible. Are not compatible. Brimming with energy. And brimming with energy means incest, guys. Don't do that. We'll learn by leveling up or raising a team. And egg moves. Pretty much egg moves are pretty much moves a Pokemon can get from an egg from the father. And what makes egg moves unique is that they are not TM moves, nor are they moves that the child can learn normally. So, there's always a Pokemon that can learn like at least one good egg move, so always consider that if you ever want to get into competitive. Alright, our final question for the edit lecture. It would be easy to find an egg between the male and female of which kind of Pokemon? Same Pokemon, because if you breed like two Pokemon within the same family, the chances of making an egg is much faster. They're like two different species of Pokemon. Alright, let's test ourselves. It prevents freezing for 5 turns after use. Sunny day. Because, you know, the sun melts the ice. Of the following, which is Electrode's highest stat? Speed, because it's a suicide bomb, literally. It inflicts double the damage if the opponent is switching out. What move is this? Pursuit? Okay, keep trying. If the opponent is a ground type Pokemon, which type should be switched out for the best advantage? Of the following, which move works regardless of type? Cotton Spore. I actually have to think on that one, I ain't gonna lie. What if the following is Painfoot's move type? Normal. Surprisingly, Sandslash can learn which of the following moves. Why is that surprising? It has claws. Which is the normal type move that Meganium can learn? Body Slam. Yes. Which Pokemon can pass down an egg move when it is left in daycare? Male. I had to look at the other options, but none of this makes sense. Which Pokemon would benefit from holding the item Fixed Club? Battleback, because we heard this like 10 times in this goddamn academy. You are such a shitty professor. And I qualified. I am the best. And so that concludes all of El's dumb little lectures. Thank you guys for watching. On the next episode, we will take on the last 4 students of the academy. I will see you guys then. Thank God we're done. I can stop using this voice.